Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and on the test bench today we're taking a look at the Simon McBride signature fuzz and octave pedal from Flattley Pedals, named after lead designer and head honcho Paul Flattley, and not the Lord of the Dance as I was labouring under the misapprehension of until fairly recently. It is essentially two pedals in one, stacking Flattley's very, very cool sounding Poison Ivy octave harmonic fuzz over on this side, with all sorts of other harmonic generating devices over here, including a bass synth and a green ringer. And there's a couple of foot switch options for some interesting tones that we'll hear in just a moment. But before we go any further, let's carry on with the same settings we have so far, but we're gonna try it with some single coils. Now, in the intro, you heard me playing my Paul Reed Smith Custom 22 through a Victory VX100 Super Kraken set clean. We'll explore some dirty sounds in a moment, but for the time being, let's stick with the same settings. We'll grab the Silver Sky and we'll hear how the fuzz section sounds. So Flattley Pedals describe the Poison Ivy fuzz as a bit of a, and I quote, Velcro ripper, and we can hear why. It's really got that kind of sort of texture, especially on the top end, but the tone switch down here is doing quite a lot to mitigate that harsh sound that you sometimes get from this kind of fuzz. What I'm going to do very quickly is I'll just flip it over for you, and you'll hear the difference between the mid-pushed and the more full range setting over on this end. Very quickly, this is the setting we're on so far. And flipping it across. Now that slightly more full range sound is a bit less cutting, but it may cooperate very well with a slightly more dirty amplifier, such as the crunch channel on our Super Kraken. Let's stick with the Silver Sky and we'll throw it through the front end and we'll hear how it sounds. So with a more broken up kind of tone, the two settings on the tone control become a lot more usable, and it's really just a question of which character you prefer. Now, moving on to the octave generator side, there's a lot to talk about here because we essentially have two octave type pedals bundled into one. There's a green ringer, which is activated with this toggle switch over here. I will talk to you more about that in a moment. And there's also a bass harmonic synth. So we're gonna begin with that one, and we can engage these pedals independently. So if we knock the octave side onto our kind of slightly broken up sound, it'll give us this. Which is adding in a fat sounding low subharmonic note, but we also have a ringer switch, which is going to engage a secondary green ringer circuit, which is like the octave part of a great octave fuzz. And that's going to give us kind of an upper octave that's going to be glitchy in the way that you'd expect to find from a great Octavia, but it's going to be independent of our fuzz sound, so we can stack it on top of other sounds to our heart's content. And both of these octave controls are brought in and out using this handy mix control over here. So if you turn it this way, it's almost all the clean sound, and as you turn it back, it's going to take us almost all the way to the octave synth generators, if you want to call them synth generators, but you know what I'm talking about. Let's listen to the same sound with the ringer on. Thank you. Now, throughout that jam, you heard me engaging and disengaging the stabilize switch. All that's doing is slightly stabilizing the low octave to stop it from getting too out of control when we're playing chords or very, very low notes. Now, one more setting we have, if we stick with this, is the bass only switch. And this is going to give us only the low octave, which will sound like this. And that is a monophonic sound, like an old Boss Octava, rather than the polyphonic, clean, digital sort of sound that you would expect from something like a Pog. But for my money, I feel like these slightly glitchy octave sounds have a lot more character to them, and they're really much more in my kind of wheelhouse. And the great thing about this kind of pedal is that you can stack these settings on top of the Fuzz, or you can stack them into your favorite pedals or your favorite dirty amp, which we're gonna try now. So ignoring the Fuzz for the time being, we're going to switch across to the dirty channel on the Super Kraken, and we'll see how the octave side behaves, feeding a much, much, much dirtier sound. So as you can hear, by feeding these octave sounds into a dirty amp, it really brings out the character of both the low and high octaves. And when you engage the bass only switch, the stabilized control has a very profound effect on exactly how much of that girthy low fuzz you're gonna get. Now, we have just tried that into a dirty amp. One last thing we're gonna do is take a quick tour around the octave sounds feeding the Poison Ivy fuzz. So while there's no doubt that the fuzz and the octave both work great as stacking options into different sounds, it's really when you combine them that the magic of this pedal starts to become clear. The sounds that you can conjure for heavy riffing and interesting, thick-sounding single note lines are practically endless. And when you throw in combinations of guitars and amplifiers, especially given how well the Poison Ivy gets on with different kinds of amps, it really is up to your creativity to plumb the limits of this kind of pedal. So anyway, had a lot of fun showing this one to you today, guys. As you know, I do love myself some fuzz, and this is a really fine fuzz. Ladies and gentlemen, the Simon McBride Signature Fuzz from Flattley Effects. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive, and I will see you next time.